Hi, Michaela here. Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another speed build. It's been a couple of weeks since I posted my last speed build, and it was because I was fairly busy with university and it was quite hard for me to do videos. Well, not that much about building because I have been building, but I didn't really have a lot of time for editing and doing voiceovers because it might seem quite easy and not so time consuming, but trust me, the process can get very lengthy. And so yeah, I just needed the time to kind of pre-record some videos so I could have kind of like an extra time, because I was like running quite late, and the only free day that I have from uni is Friday, and that's the day I am supposed to have my speed build out. So it's pretty much impossible to finish the video on Friday because my Wi-Fi is too slow to upload on during the day, because otherwise my family would have like completely dead Wi-Fi during the day, and since my dad works from home, it would not be very nice to him. So I have to do it before, so it means that I always do the video a week prior, and I wasn't ahead at the moment because I had some uni stuff that I had to take care of and I was running kind of late. I can't guarantee this won't happen in the future because I have classes till like till Christmas technically. Then I have my exams. That should be quite fine. My summer semester should be a bit less busy, but it's going to be also my final year, so I'll be have to studying for finals, and for I will also have to be writing my bachelor thesis. So yeah, for now I'll stay with one video a week and we'll see. Sometimes I might just not post a video on some weeks. Anyway, let's move on to the build because I've been talking about myself for the first 2.5 minutes. So the build, it's located on a 30 by 20 in Willow Creek, and it comes in at 63,499 simoleons. So it's not like super expensive, but it's not cheap either. It's definitely not a starter home. I was inspired by a picture I saw on Pinterest, I think. But I have a lot of pictures in my phone for inspiration at the moment because I have a lot of ideas and not enough time to build. Okay, so I have a lot of pictures in my phone, and I must have deleted this one. So yet again, I don't have the inspiration picture on me right now, which is a shame because it was a pretty picture. I kind of added some stuff on top of it because, you know, obviously the dimensions and everything is a little bit different in The Sims than it is in real life. But I really like the way it turned out. I was a little bit skeptical at the beginning because I struggled with the shape of the house a little bit and how to use the full lot. But I think it turned out pretty nice. I like the landscaping a lot. It's very lush and pretty and green, and I've been struggling with landscaping a little bit lately, so I feel like this is kind of nice and better than it was. I've been in general, I've been very inspired to build lately, like very. I have so many inspiration pictures. I've been spending so much time on Pinterest lately because I don't know, I just love it. I just love getting inspired. But I felt a little bit, you know, the imposter syndrome was kicking in, or is still kicking in, because I feel like my builds are not good enough, not pretty enough, or not good enough. So I've been struggling with that a little bit lately. So I've been the last couple of builds that I did, I In the meantime, from my last speed build to this one, I think I built those like three structures because I just wasn't feeling it. I just wasn't feeling the looks of them. I just wasn't liking what I was seeing. So it took me a while to get to this build again, because I think this is the second one that I did on this lot, because I tried something different first, but I didn't like it at all. So I did something different. I don't know. I just been struggling a lot with liking what I'm building. I love building. It's so much fun. It's an amazing activity for me. Something that can't quite compare to anything else, because it's a creative outlet for me that I don't really have anywhere else apart from drawing, because I do draw a little bit, but still, it's one of my favorite creative outlets, and I've been really loving it recently, like the past year and a half. But I've been struggling a little bit with liking what I'm creating, so yeah, that was also a small part of the fact why I did not post for a while, because I was not happy with how the stuff that I was building were looking as well. So yeah, so we're working on the living room here. I really love the items from Dream Home Decorator. Still, I am just obsessed with them, even if it's quite some time since we got the pack. I can't even remember. It feels like forever ago, but yeah. But I really like the items still, and I am still overusing them because they're just cute and perfect and just my style. I really like, this is a house for two Sims at most. I was thinking maybe just a single Sim lives here. Maybe they're working on their career, maybe they're having fun. They're just enjoying their life in this little house. But I guess they have to be fairly good at what they do. I was thinking that this person who, or this Sim that lives here, is a designer, because I don't know, I just like the idea, and I made a little office in the bedroom too, so the Sim could work from home. So I don't know, I felt like the person who lives here, or the Sim that lives here, sorry, is a designer. So I use a lot of modern furniture and chic stuff, and I really like how it turned out. As I said, I wasn't really sure at the beginning if I liked it or not, but I think it turned out pretty good. We're working on the kitchen, just cluttering it up. I used these counters from Dream Home Decorator again, because they are just cute, perfect, modern, nice. I don't know. I don't know what I'm saying, okay? I did not use a lot of clutter. I wanted to keep it to a level that was not too much. And I initially used the green, not backsplash, but the bricks on the walls throughout the entire house, but I later on changed them to black because I felt it looked a little bit better. I also really loved the idea of this island. I think I saw it like in someone's post on Instagram, and I felt like it was perfect. It was just genius, because these, you know, normally they are like squares, so that looks weird, but this particular counter, it makes the like hexagonal shape pretty much, I think, so it looks really, really cool. So I was really happy about that. I also put some stuff down for pet. I'm not sure if I thought about a dog or a cat, but I definitely did not place a litter box, so maybe a dog. But I think I put a cat toy somewhere, but still, there is no litter box. So if you want to have a cat here, you'll have to add a litter box if you decide to download this build and use it for you. Yeah, sorry about that. I completely forgot about that. If you want to download this build, it will be available, or it is already available on my gallery. My ID is Michaela Sims YT, and it's also available as tray files in the description of this video if you prefer to get built into your game that way. So yeah, I'll just go back to talking about myself because I haven't spoken to you in a while. So I released with a bunch of other swimmers a save file, which was called the Sweater Weather save file, and that was, I had footage for my my build, but it was just, it was too overwhelming at that point because it was already, I had a 64x64, in case you haven't seen the build. I did a 64x64 lot because I was the last one to pick, and obviously the big one, the big lot, was the last one left. So I got the 64x64, which meant that it took me forever to do the lot itself, and the footage was so fucking long, and I just couldn't. I could not make myself to edit all of the footage with everything that was going on at school, a lot of work, a lot of things I had to do, and I just couldn't. So I decided to just delete the footage and don't do anything about it. I also started working on an A-frame house, but I forgot to tape it. So I have it in the works in case I need to build without a video somewhere in the future, but I wasn't really sure I like it that much anymore. But I like the idea of an A-frame, so I might do another one sometime soon. So we're now working on the bathroom. It's fairly simple. There is a tub and there is also a closet in here. I know it's not very practical because, you know, your clothes would get from the humidity, they would kind of soak in the water, but I like the idea, so I just went with it, I guess. I have the bedroom partially done because I changed the layout of I changed the bed and the area after, so I kept it out because the beam build is already not long, but it's longer than I would like it to be because I prefer like 15 minute videos, so it's a little bit longer. So I decided to keep this out, and you will just see when I decide to change the bed. I also added this mirror from Jungle Adventure, and I later on kind of move it to the other side because I've shuffled things around. I think with the fact that I've been very self-critical about my work, about what I do, I've been changing stuff a lot because I don't like them. I don't like the way they look. So I've been changing stuff a lot. I've been very indecisive with colors lately. I've been very indecisive about styles and about what to put where. So bear with me, I guess. It's a process. I hope I will get through this. Not necessarily a block, but this kind of crisis of identity when it comes to building. And now you can see I changed the bed. And now I'm changing the brick, as I said, to black, because I felt like it added more of a chic look to the house. Also, I have not been playtesting my builds at all lately because I just, it's very overwhelming, unfortunately. So in case something doesn't work, I'm sorry, it might. But you have to deal with it yourself because I just can't. So playtesting my build is something I've been forgetting very often, and it's just too overwhelming and too much for me. So I hope it's okay because I don't want to upset anyone, but I will not playtest my build anymore because I can't. Sorry. About that. Never mind. We've moved on to the exterior of the house. I used these wall planters from Seasons. And I hid them into wall, and I also lowered them with the tool mod, so they looked like they're like directly onto wall, and I felt like it looked perfect. I was really happy about the idea. I also put a grill, a table for the Sims to sit in. I also made like a lounge, relax area outside with these chairs from Get Together, and I put a rug and a coffee table here as well. I think it would be nice, you know, to sit out here, enjoy the nice weather of Willow Creek, and just have fun. I really liked the way it looked, the way it turned out, and I really liked the colors of the pillows. I wish we had more items that have this kind of raspberry pink color, because that's the kind of pink I like. I'm not very keen on pink, but this pink is pretty awesome. Also put some planters, and now we are... Oh yeah, I didn't know what to do with this space. I was kind of lost a little bit, so I decided to place sort of like a garden house, which is a gym and a place for wellness. So there is a massage chair, like the chair from Spa Day. There is a yoga mat. There is a meditation stool, and there is also a treadmill, and that's it, I think, and some mirrors as well. So it's like a outdoor gym slash wellness area, and I don't know, I love the idea. When I finished, I felt like it's perfect. So maybe the sim, you know, likes to work on themselves, because, you know, they have a very sedentary job, because, you know, they create like plans for every all the renovations. So I felt like it was perfect to make them a little gym in the garden. And I didn't obviously have the space for it inside the house, so I made this little garden house instead. Maybe it was a shed when they bought it, and the sim renovated it and made it into their own sort of like a sanctuary. And I don't know, I loved it. I was really happy with the idea. I also used this base game console table, cluttered up with some plants and decorations. And on the other side of the room, there's going to be the treadmill. I also put some of the like wardrobes from like a wardrobes, like a locker from Snowy Escape, some chair, and I think that's pretty much it for the house itself. So yeah, thank you guys so much for stopping by. I would really appreciate if you liked this video, if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And yeah, thank you so much for stopping by, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!